The same cooking oil being used at the KU dining hall can one day be used to help power the KU buses. I think that's really exciting.
I'm Professor Susan Williams, Associate Professor in Chemical and Petroleum Engineering at the University of Kansas, and I'm also the Director of the KU Biodiesel Initiative. We get all of our used cooking oil from Mrs. Z's Dining Services right now. It's a small fraction of what they actually produce on campus, but we get about 35 to 40 gallons a week. So we get a barrel of used cooking oil that comes in every Thursday afternoon. We transfer this barrel through a pumping system into this particular barrel here, which is for settling. You can see that we're filtering it through a plastic filter that allows us to remove some of the solids before we actually get it into the barrel. When we transfer it over, it tends to have a lot of solid material that's in the oil. So we can heat this barrel up, and when we heat it up, we can get the solid material to settle out to the bottom. If we don't heat it up, we usually have to let it sit for about a week in order to be able to let all that material settle down. With the heating up, we can generally get that to happen out in about 15 to 20 minutes. Once we get everything settled out of the barrel, we can actually take the used cooking oil. We pump it through this system and deposit it into preheat barrels for our reactors. Once the oil is in here, then the oil is ready to be heated and ready to be processed into biodiesel. Once we pump it into the reactor, we add the catalyst. And the catalyst is a mixture of potassium hydroxide and methanol. We put in 40 gallons of oil into the reactor, and we've added about 8 gallons of the methanol and potassium hydroxide mixture. The reactor is operating at about 55 degrees Celsius. We will run the reaction for approximately 3 hours. Now we're pumping the reacted material over into the settling tank. And in this tank, the biodiesel and the glycerin separate out. The biodiesel is currently being washed. We wash it 3 times to remove any of the methanol, any of the unreacted product, and any of the soap that may have formed in the process. The biodiesel is now being spray dried into this barrel, in which we can remove any residual water that might be into the biodiesel. From where it will be pumped into the storage drums and put into storage until it's used on campus.